What's up, YouTube? Guess who's back with the vlog? It's me. I am back with the vlog. I've been on a little bit of about a year hiatus. COVID hit and the whole world shut down, including my world, because we had school and stuff to get done. But if you look here, literally anywhere on the screen, you might notice some increased quality, because today we got a brand new camera and lens for the vlog. In case you're interested, if you're like cameras or you're just a technology nerd, we got the Canon EOS RP. It is the first, it's like a cheaper version of the first full frame lens. I have yet to have a full frame camera. If you don't know what that means, this camera has a full frame. My other camera, the picture with the same exact lens on would have looked like this. So that's a benefit. So the vlogs will be looking really crisp recently, practice vlogs, and they're gonna be looking nice and fresh. I had to start the vlog off with my ever delicious Lucky Charms with Bang, because I had some people out there thinking I didn't do it, or they didn't believe me, but I do in fact do it quite often. Haven't been doing it recently because of for Lent, I was supposed to give up sugar, and it's going okay. I had this 3-week period where on my clinical, my CI and I were just pounding bags of candy. That's where I got the idea to come up with no sugar for Lent. But then when I realized that I didn't have that much sugar in the rest of my diet, it really didn't become that hard to give up sugar for Lent. So we'll see how, I think I'm gonna switch to fasting. Anyway, we are going to do meal prep for this week, see what I eat to kind of get back into the swing of things. I've been in a car for the past 30 hours plus hours. I drove back from Phoenix. I was on a clinical rotation out there at Foothills Sports Medicine, and now I'm back in Columbus for the last 6 weeks before I graduate, and then we're on to bigger and better things. So let's get started. And I basically need to meal prep some healthy food, because I've been eating absolute garbage for the past 3 weeks or 3 days. And garbage, I mean combos, energy drinks, and coffee. So let's get this vlog started and see what Jacob makes this week for dinner. Well, I was gonna show you, start the video off with a cool drone shot, but apparently with the Karma GoPro drones, there's a update firmware that will not let you take off without calibration. So I'm just gonna take you to the actual view itself. This is the new crib. It's the view on Grant, because of the view. Been living here since last June, but technically I was in Phoenix for 10 weeks, so this is the first time I've seen this view. I was gonna do a nice drone shot, but not today. Ava. All right, we got everything that we need for an absolute delicacy of a lunch this week. I've been eating this for almost the past month now, and low carb, good amount of protein, but also very tasty. All right, let's go over everything we need. Up first, we got some bag of frozen cauliflower, bag of frozen peppers and onions, some cilantro, as long as it doesn't taste like soap to you, some tomato paste, some lime juice, some Mexican style cheese. I have the reduced fat version because I'm having cheese in two meals this week, but you can get whatever kind you want. You need some breast, and I mean chicken breast. And that's about it. You just put this all into a bowl, and you put this in the microwave first, so to save some time We already got this bad boy. Oh, she's leaking. Where are you coming from? Oh. All right. It's literally just all the vegetables sauteed up, some cilantro, then the tomato paste. Just use like 2 scoops of the tomato paste. Then just gotta sprinkle some onion powder. Some garlic powder. And you got your lime juice. And then you just mix, which is kind of hard to do with one hand. There we are. So you ever still have a little Spanish rice style, low carb, rice type thing. There she is. All right, here is the finished product. Put up in the light. It looks a lot better in person than it does on camera. But less than 500 calories, sprinkle some cheese on it, and you got yourself a pretty good low carb meal. That's about it. Kind of tired now. Even though I only made food for like 20 minutes. So I'm probably gonna make my pizza. It's pizza Sunday. So I'm gonna make my pizza and then wrap this food up. And then we'll end the vlog with a little conversation about where we've been and where we're going. All right. Alright, it is pizza Sunday, so we have our pizza here. It is a tombstone four meat, if you can see that. We've got pineapple, mushroom, and onion on it, and then the four meats. Typically, I've been eating this pizza now for the specific toppings for over a year now. I'm a big pineapple and pizza person, if you can't tell. In full transparency, I did have pizza last night with Dad after I got home, dropping Mom off after our 30-hour road trip across the country. That being said, this kind of lends into why I wanted to sit down and talk about the vlog and why I decided now to restart the vlog. It's been a hit or miss over the past 2 years of how consistent I am with this vlog. But I feel like the past 10 weeks being out in Arizona, I had a lot of time just to think about what I wanted for life and where I wanted to go. And I know what my end goal is. I just don't necessarily know exactly how it's going to work out. But that doesn't matter, because you just got to show up each day and see where the wind takes you. I'm just being a leaf and letting the wind take me where I need to go. The wind's the Holy Spirit, if you haven't picked up on that yet. But in all seriousness, when I was out in Phoenix, I made a choice about 4 weeks ago to not stay out in Phoenix after graduation and work out in Phoenix. I decided instead to take the step of faith and start my private practice right after graduation. I have no idea what my life's going to look like after May 7th, but I know what my end goal is, and I'll do whatever it takes to get there. So it's a huge step of faith, not having guaranteed money, but I want to document everything that happens from here on out. I had a lot of time to think in Phoenix and just kept coming back to two words, and that's Without Fear, which is one of my favorite songs by Dermot Kennedy. And yeah, I just can't have fear with anything in life, especially with my private practice, life getting serious. I've never graduated, not had education following that graduation, so this is a big step in life that I think I'm ready to take. Well, I know I'm ready to take, because I better be ready, because it's coming fast. So it's going to be 6 weeks of board studying, practicum. My practicum is going to be with two gentlemen that one owns private practice, one does physical therapy private practice consulting. And it's going to be 6 weeks of prepping me for everything there is to know about private practice, physical therapy, and social media, marketing, business administration. So not a lot of patient care over the next 6 weeks, but I'm pretty excited for that. I'm just excited for what the future holds, because right now I have no idea what it's going to hold, but that's exciting for me. I like having the challenge and the excitement of taking that step in faith and stepping into the unknown and just trusting God that He will provide, because if I give up control, then that's when everything good comes. Give control to God. I still have to show up each day and do things. But I'm going to wrap this up here. Got my pizza, and then I got some champagne for literally no reason except to celebrate life. It doesn't take for me a lot to celebrate something, but I don't know. I think there's everything, every day in life, there's something to appreciate. We pass by so much time in each of our days, not paying attention to the smallest of things. And that's where all of the beauty is held in each day. So, I'm gonna pour myself this glass of champagne. Doesn't sound too promising. That made a mess, but gonna pour this to celebrate life, and yeah, I hope that you guys can find some joy and peace in your day this week, and just remember that life is worth living, and it's a great day to have a great day. It's a great day to be alive. That all being said, cheers to the new beginnings of an adventure that I have no idea what it's gonna look like, but really anything in life. I have no idea what my life's going to look like after May 7th, so cheers to the unknown and having faith and taking that step. So Also, pro tip, wait for at least 5 minutes for your pizza to cool before you start cutting it. It makes a world of difference in the conciseness of where your toppings land and the precision of your cut. So that's just a small pro tip that you can take home and really impress somebody when you're cutting your pizza next time. All right, peace out, everybody. Good night and sleep tight.